What's going on, guys? It's your boy Adjen back again for another Alchemy Stars video, and for today we've gotten two patch notes from Turdog. So the first patch note is all about the upcoming Persona 5 Royal collaboration, Heist Under a Moonlit Night. So this one will start on after the maintenance on July 14, more or less 2 days from now. This one, we will be getting 2 multi-summon as expected. So, log in to claim collaboration 10 times recruitment spirit times 2. This is a worth 2 multis worth of pool. And you can only use this one on the Persona collaboration banner. You cannot use this summon resources in any other banner except for the collaboration banner. I will be using this one on Queen's banner. I hope I can get Queen very early on, so that I can try and get Joker with my remaining resources. It seems to me that there will be no story attached to the Persona collaboration, judging on the patch notes. Yeah, because it says here that overview of the Persona 5 Royal Collab event, Heist Under a Moonlit Night, will only be available for a limited time. During the event, consume pre-sim to clear the specified stages, main stages and resource stages. See? Main stages and resource stages only. And you'll get an additional event item, infiltration points. So yeah, this is just a farming event, just like the one from the Dragon Maid collaboration, which is such a shame. They still don't, what do you call this? They still did not listen to the player base regarding the first collaboration with the Dragon Maid, because during that, our very first collaboration does not have a story attached to it. There's no story event. And maybe that is why we are also getting another story event at the same time with the Persona collaboration. Such a shame. Come on, Turdog. When will you learn? When will you listen to your player base regarding the collaboration? You put a lot of effort with the collaboration. Why not go all out with that one? And I know Turdog is very good with when it comes to storytelling. Sorry about I'm stuttering. I just woke up. And yeah, as I've said, Turdog is good with storytelling, but they cannot implement it with the upcoming Persona collaboration. It is such a shame. Such a shame. So these are the prizes that you can get. So we are getting also this box. This is a 5-star selector box where we can pick out Violet and Pax, as I predicted, because this is the same as the one from the Dragon Maid collaboration. And these are the items that we can also get from the event. The bus is pretty good. The stop toy is pretty good also. But that's it. That is all the Persona collaboration offers. New units, new mechanics, and some pre-pulls. And the usual pre-beast, the usual ascension materials, upgrade materials. And yeah, that's it. And then we will have the Aurorian trial for the collaboration. And that's it. There's no story attached to it. And then some login events. I think this one will be a pretty lackluster collaboration again. Same like with the Dragon Maid, because there is no story attached to this one. These are just the details for the banner. The first 10 pulls have a minimum 5-star. And then it only explains the PT mechanics. There's nothing new to this one. And then community activities, obtain exclusive furniture. I don't really pay attention to those details anyway. Now, let's move on to the other patch notes, which is the event announcement, Journey at Dawn, Wondrous Beast Encounters. So, this is the journey of the nerf Hestia. Hestia from Danmachi. We are getting 2 collaboration, guys. Persona collaboration and Danmachi collaboration. I think this one is pog. This one is pretty high because this one is a story event, and we all know, as I've said, Tour Dog is really good with when it comes to storytelling. This probably will be a very interesting story as long as they don't pack up the translation. So you can participate in this event once you unlock the main stage 1-16. And then there will be some Cloud Garden event again. A lot of players are complaining about the abundance of events that takes place in the Cloud Garden because some players can only play on a low spec phone and they cannot handle the graphics for the Cloud Garden, so they cannot participate in most of the event that includes Cloud Garden. The best part of the patch is this one, guys. The Four Angels Recommended Recruitment Banner. This is the best banner, in my honest opinion, out of the upcoming banners. Because the only 6 star that you can get from this banner are the Four Angels. Gabriel, Uriel, Michael, and Raphael. All of these angels are pretty good. Especially Michael. Michael is broken, guys. So if you don't have Michael, this is a good chance to grab a copy of your Michael. And you have a 25% chance. Although the RRR banner is still good because that one is you have a 50-50 chance to get the recommended Aurorian there. But here it is still pretty good enough because your choices is only these four. And not only this one, guys. The 5 stars included in this banner are also selective. You can only get Faust, Maggie, Pak, Sikare, Barton, Klecke, Nemesis, Beverly, Hydrad, and Aria. All of these are pretty damn good. Most of these one are converter except for Aria. And yes, all the 5-star cross-style converters are here. Maggie, Sikare, Barton, and Nemesis can all be gotten here. And also the initial portal converter for the 5 stars, which is Faust, Pak, Klecken and Beverly are here, and then a bonus Hydrad. I don't know why they give a bonus Hydrad, and Aria the best 5 star in terms of DPS output in the game right now. So this banner is pretty stacked, pretty good. If you have the spare regular players, then it is a good banner to summon for. I was supposed to do some summons on the Sariel and Maggie banner, but I decided not to do that one because I will just summon here because there is a chance that I can get also Maggie here and Nemesis. Those two 5 stars are the one that I'm must summon for me because those two are not yet MBT for me. So I'm hoping that I can grab a copy of Maggie and Nemesis in this banner. This banner is pretty good, guys, but this banner will only start on July 21 until August 4. And then the update for Nina and Sanae are now added to the standard pool. And then we have the battle pass where we can get a free Brock skin, and then for paying players the Hattie Leona skin will be available. Yes, this is a must buy for me because of Leona skin. Have you watched my previous video? Will you lose your F2P status for Leona? Good luck, guys. Good luck. Good luck to the F2P players. And also this one. If Smokey is your waifu and your F2P, would you lose your F2P status? Me, I cannot control myself with this one. This one is a must buy for me also. Your boy is sure going to buy this one. And this one is attached with a special star player, which is pretty nice, pretty good. That is a good bundle for me. So yes, I am buying this skin and also the battle pass. And then some skins are returning. Sadly, it is not the Icy, which is I'm really hoping for to come back because I really want that Icy skin. But it is what it is. We will be getting Iridon and Maggie. I already have Maggie since I've already purchased that battle pass before. And then what else? And then some packs. The usual packs. And no more. Some additional Cloud Garden supports. Okay. Okay, that's it. There's nothing more. That's all for the upcoming update this July 14. So we will be getting two events, the Persona collaboration and this Journey at Dawn 1 plus Beast Encounters story event. So these three new characters are still unknown. We still don't know their names, but we will get their names when the update becomes live. So yeah, that's it for me for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please leave a like and subscribe. I would really appreciate it if you could help me grow my channel more. And thank you to everyone who are supporting my channel. I appreciate every one of you. Until next time, peace!